Hi everyone, I'm Grayson and I'm one of the senior officers on the Coronado Cougarettes, and this is your jazz triad combo. There are two or three parts where there are alternative to certain moves, so if you want to take that alternative, I'll let you know. Alright, when you do your jazz combo, there will be about 3 to 4 8 counts in the beginning where you can do improv, and that'll be whatever you want. So if you want to throw tricks, turns, leaps, or just doing movement, whatever you want in those 3 to 4 8 counts. When we do start though, we'll start facing the front, and it'll go, and, so you're gonna cross with your right foot, and your arms are coming up into a dagger's position with your palms facing your shoulders. One, your arm will come from your daggers around into an L with your right arm up and your left arm out in a T, and your hands are basketball hands, and your left leg will flick out with a straight leg, flex foot, and it'll run and jump around. So from front, you'll go and one, you'll come down clean to the front, two, with your left foot crossing in front. Then you'll step out on three to the diagonal with your head still facing front and your right arm will swoop forward. Your left arm is still clean. On four, you'll do the same movement with your left hand and then your head will go from the front down and then you'll drop your body too. You'll have about a flat back as well. From four, you come up five, you're facing the diagonal, your arms are in the same dagger's position as the beginning, and you're up in a parallel releve. Six, you come down, your fingertips are touching the ground, and both legs are bent in a flat back lunge. And you rock back, seven, eight. Seven, your arms are coming forward with basketball hands, eight, they come behind you, and you're arching back as much as possible with your right foot flexed. All right, let's go from the top. So you have your improv, and you go, and one, two, right arm three, left arm four, up five, six, rock back seven, eight. If you need to rewind that, go ahead and pause it right now, or we'll just keep going up. So you rock back seven, eight. From here, you'll come down one, and you'll have flat hands, fingertips, whatever you need for this part, to come down two. On that part, you're going down on your toes, and your right leg is crossing on top of your left. So two, you're gonna push on your hands to swivel three, four. On four, you're facing the complete back, and you'll point your left arm up on five. You'll lead with your hand on six, with your head kind of following in suit, and you're gonna roll seven, eight. On seven, eight, your feet are together, your hands are facing inwards, and you're flat down, your stomach is flat to the ground. From seven, eight, you're still rolling one, two, and you'll kind of face the side to go three, four, and that's the pretty batma, however you want it. And your right arm will come up and it'll keep reaching forward. So three, four, you'll come up five, six. When you stand up, have presence about yourself. Don't just stand up like you just got off the floor. It's a dance. You come up five, six, to go seven, eight. So seven, you're still crossing, or you're stepping with your right foot, your arms are still clean. Eight, your arms are starting to come up and they'll come to the left with basketball hands. Woo! You'll see this a lot. All right, let's go from you rocked seven, eight. So you rock back seven, eight, you come down one, on your toes two, down three, back four, point up five, six, roll seven, eight, one, two, kick three, four, five, stand six, seven, eight. If you need to pause that, rewind it, go ahead. We're going to keep moving on. So you just went seven, eight. You're going to be, this is the start of a ball change on eight. So one will be you're stepping back onto that left foot with your right foot out in a degage kind of position. And your arms are coming around. So from left to right. So technically your movement doesn't stop on eight. It keeps going. And it just goes through eight. So seven, eight, one. And your head will look to the side on one. You'll hold that two to go three. You're starting to do a shane, a three-step turn, and your knees are bent and you're on four starch. You'll go three, you're starting to go into like this weird L, and yes, you'll have these kind of happy hands kind of position, to come four. Your left arm will come up from top, it'll wrap around your head, your right arm will wrap around your waist. From here, you're still in four starch. On five, six, you're opening up, and that hits super sharp. Your feet come down, you're still in this kind of bent position with your knees, and you hit sharp, open. It's not totally straight, but it's not totally bent either. Somewhere in the middle, like you're coming from second position, and your head shoots up on five, six. To prep, seven, eight. For your turn set, woo! We love turn sets. This is where we have alternatives. So if you are more of a beginner in turns, or you don't quite know how to do Alice Cone turns yet, just do Alice Cone straight to the front. I'll give you those counts in a second. And if you're more advanced, or you know turns pretty well, we're gonna be taking them inverted. So for my friends who are doing just straightforward Alice Cone, you go five, six, prep, seven, eight. You go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. And then you'll pull into a double. Five, six, down, seven, eight. And you'll land in a CC position, which is one arm in front, one arm in back. For my friends who are doing inverted turns, you're still doing the same prep. You'll go five, six, prep, seven, eight. You'll go one, two, three, four, then you'll hit side five, back six, side seven, front eight, to go one, two, three, four, pull into a double, five, six, land seven, eight, in that same CC position. All right, so decide whichever one you want. We'll go ahead and go, we'll go from seven, eight, just kind of going over counts, and then we'll go from the top up until there. So we come up, we bottom out three, four, come up five, six, seven, eight, push one, two, three, four, sit five, six, prep, seven, eight, go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, double five, six, land seven, hold eight. If you need to rewind that, go ahead and just do that part a few times. If you need to practice the turn set, definitely do that. But we're gonna be going from the top now. So in the beginning, you have your improv, whatever you want for your improv. Five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, right arm, three, four, up, five, six, rock, seven, eight, one, two, three, back, four, point, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, kick, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, sit, five, six, prep, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, double, six, seven, land, eight. If you need to rewind that, whatever you need, go ahead and do that. We'll go a little bit faster now, just so then you can kind of do it. I don't know if it'll be up to turning speed. But yeah, here we go. So you improv, you do whatever you want. Then you go five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, three, four, five, six, rock, seven, eight. One, down, two, three, four, point, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, kicks, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, six, five, six, five, seven, eight, go one, two, three, four, five, six, eight, one, two, three, four, double five, six, seven, and eight. Cool. I bet you did amazing. You did fantastic. We're gonna keep going on. Cool. So you just landed the most amazing turn set of your life on seven, eight. From here, you're gonna turn your body to that corner, to the left corner, on one, two. So your left arm comes from the front, it comes to the back, and it's slightly bent with energy.
Your right arm comes from the back. It comes and swings around to the front, and it caresses your face to have like a little Maddie Ziegler kind of moment. And this is, you're also parallel. I would say you're facing corner a little bit more, but you are hip width apart for your legs. From here, you go 1, 2. You open up into a T3 to start shunning in a low plie, 4, 5, 6, I believe, to then calypso on 7. If you don't know what a calypso is, your front leg, in this case it's your right leg, will be straight, and your back leg, which is your left leg right now, will be in an attitude position, which is just bent. If you're starting out with calypsos, I would say have your arms in an L, which means your left arm will be up by your ear, and your right arm will be out in a T. But if you are more advanced with calypsos, you can go ahead and try to arch back, and you can do different arms. My favorite arms are kind of wrapping around my shoulders, or you can reach to the front with a beautiful arch. So you go with that calypso, you come 1, 2, open 3, 4, 5, 6, up 7, 8. Try to suspend that calypso too, that'll look really pretty. 7, 8, you're rolling 1, 2, you're up by 3. It's a fast roll, so make sure you really whip and spot your head. You're up 3, 4, and this is 2 reaches of whatever you want. You could go 5, 6, you could go 5, 6, you could go 5, 6, whatever you want for those reaches. It's dancer's choice, pretty much. So you're up 3, 4, you reach 5, 6, to look 7, and you're not necessarily slapping. If slapping helps, go ahead. But you come back with those bent arms and they have energy in them, and you're still looking side on 7 to prep 8. And instead of turn sets, you're gonna be just doing a regular pirouette. For this, you could either do a double, a triple, or if you're feeling up for it, a quad. But whatever you want, and for auditions, we would rather see a clean double rather than a hoppy, kind of sloppy triple. So whatever you feel up to doing. But you'll go 7, 8, you'll go 1, 2, 3, 4. Whatever you do, you're landing up in this kind of releve position. If you're hitting a double, you can extend your arms a little bit more, but if you're hitting that quad, you may only just have time to hit up. All right, that was a lot. So let's go from we just landed the turn set. I'll count out this part. So you just doubled 5, 6, land 7, hold 8. You come around 1, 2, open 3, 4, 5, 6, calypso 7, 8, roll 1, 2, three, stand 4, 2 reaches of 5, 6, look 7, prep 8, go 1, 2, 3, 4, up 5. Rewind that if you need, but we're gonna go on and we're almost done. So you just landed a double, triple, and quad, and everyone's up here by 5. On 6, you're gonna melt to your right leg. So all of your weight will be more on your right leg. You should be able to lift up your left leg, but we're not doing that. So you lift, you lean onto your right leg, and your arms will break. You'll lean more to the diagonal, and from them being straight, they go and bend. So they have a slight bend to them, and this you can kind of do whatever you want to. If you feel you want basketball hands, and then you throw, you can do that. You can go up, and then come down, and hug yourself. Whatever you want for that kind of melt. But for 5, your arms should be out in a T somewhere, and they should melt to the diagonal somewhere. So you come up here, 5, you melt 6, 7, you start turning around on 7 to go 8. And then you face the right side. So you're up 5, 6, 7, 8 to go 1. Your hands kind of slap down onto your thighs, and you're not staying here. They're gonna be coming up a little bit, kind of like you're grabbing pants or you're grabbing a skirt. So from 8, you go 1, 2, and all you're doing with that is just you're replacing your left foot to go where your right foot was, and your right foot comes out into a dégagé, and your arms come out into open jazz hands right above your head. go 1, 2, 3, 4. From there, you're here, you go clean 3, you step on your right foot, you clean 3, you turn to the back, and your hands come up 4. They're right by your head. Make sure we don't have little Mickey Mouse ears for that too. For 5, 6, you push away that right arm, and your left arm will come to your shoulder, and you come to a hip width position on 5, 6, to go 7, you're in a first position, and then you open up 8. Your right leg will come through, no more than 90 for this leg. It'll be flexed, and your arms will come open in a T with wide hands. Let's go from you just landed your quad. This you don't have to pause and rewind. I'm just gonna go through it really fast, and then we'll finish it. We have about like 8 counts left, I think. Yeah. All right, so you landed 1, 2, 3, 4, you're up 5, melt 6, turn 7, 8. You go 1, up 2, clean 3, head 4, look 5, 6, first 7, up 8. From up 8, you come down 1. So your arms will break in a half T. So pretty much it goes and you're also bending to come down 1. Your right arm will shoot in front of your left knee, and your left arm will be clean behind you, pretty much. And you'll be more sitting onto your left leg on 1. 2, you cross, and your left arm will be crossing over your right knee, and your weight will be more on your right knee now. So 1, 2, you come up 3, and your arms from here swivel in like a straw, and they open up with your hands on your head. 3, and you come about hip width apart to go 4, and you slap that left leg to bring it around, and this is when you'll look at your hands the entire time. So look at that left hand to go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You'll open 4, 5, you grab your right elbow on 6, and that's when that hand will go. So it kind of triggers it to then go 7. So this arm will come around and guide you to sit into this bent lunge, and your hand will be open. Then you'll come up 8. And that's, I would say, the last kind of dancer's choice, where it can be whatever leg you want. You can just hold it right in front of you. You could hold it here. You could hold it and grab it and catch it by your ankle. Whatever you want, just make sure it's a right side kind of off on 8. So you go 7, you go 8, and then you melt 1. And that melt is kind of whatever you desire, but put it behind you. So let's go from slap 1, go 2, and then we're gonna finish it. It's like 4 counts of 8 left. So you go 7, 8, slap 1, up 2, 3, look 4, push away 5, 6, first 7, 8, go down 1, 2, up 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. And you'll break on 1. So make sure you really hold this position on 8, and then go 1, 2. From here, the last 8 count. 1, 2, go push 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From there, all it is pretty much kind of like you're feeling yourself. It's like you're walking away, saying bye-bye tryouts. So you go up, you go 1, 2, you push 3, 4, 5, 6, down 7. And you're kind of ending in this down position. You can kind of do whatever you want with those arms. So you can kind of linger away, down. You can linger away, look away. Just have the direction of you're going back, and you look, and then you're down to the left. Other than that, that's it. We'll go over it I'll go over it from counts, from top to bottom, and then I'll do a pull out. Okay? So you improv, 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 5, 6, 7, 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, rock, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, roll, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, sit, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, double, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, reach, 5, 6, look, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, look, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Go ahead and pause that, rewind it, do whatever you need. But yeah, that's your jazz combo. Cool. If you have any questions, let me know via like Instagram or something like that. But yeah, cool. Okay, so this is the full out for the jazz combo. You can look the song up on YouTube. It's called Falling Slowly. And you can start the song about 2 minutes to 2:10 before the song ends. And that's gonna be including improv. All right, let's go.